Two top AEW stars are set to take an extended break, and could Disney be set to buy WWE? But first, let's get to the quickfire headlines, as last night's LA Forum AEW Dynamite would see a surprise appearance from Adam Cole, this after several months away due to suffering two serious concussions in a short amount of time. Cole would then tell fans that he has some good news and some bad news. Cole would go on to describe his time away from the ring and the struggles of coping with his post-concussion symptoms, and then he would get to the bad news, initially leading the fans to be worried about what could be coming. However, thankfully, he stated that the bad news is not for him, but for the AEW locker room, adding that he isn't done yet and wants to achieve far more in AEW, with him feeling that he's only just scratching the surface. Last night's AEW Dynamite would be main evented by a ladder match for the Trios Championships, with the Elite taking on the champions the Death Triangle in the final match of the Best of Seven series. The finish would see Kenny Omega drop Penta with a one-winged angel from a bridge ladder to the floor, allowing him to climb up and take the title belt down. The Elite now begin their second reign as Trios champions, with their first run ending after just 3 days after being involved in a real-life altercation with CM Punk, which led to them being suspended and ultimately stripped of their belts. WWE NXT announcer Sudhu Shah, who was signed in January 2022 as a play-by-play commentator for 205 Live and later the NXT Level Up show, has revealed that his time with the company is up, with him taking to Twitter to say, "Yesterday was my final day with the WWE. What an incredible experience working with some of the most talented people I've ever met. Thank you to everyone who watched and supported every week." Ever since news broke that Vince McMahon is looking to sell WWE, one potential buyer that sometimes gets mentioned is Tony Khan, whether that be jokingly or sometimes seriously. Tony's friend Conrad Thompson would discuss the possibility of this happening on the 83 Weeks podcast this week and said, "I got two phone calls last week from different people who, well, their names in the wrestling community to ask, would Tony Khan have the capacity to buy WWE? I think the answer is yes, he has the capacity. There is no question that he would be able to put together a deal, but I would put the odds of that being near zero. I don't know why Tony would do that. I don't see the upside of Tony doing that." AAA booker Conan would take to his Keeping It 100 podcast this week, where he discussed the departure of Dragon Lee, who chose to leave AAA in favour of WWE. Conan would reveal the dilemma that Dragon faced when choosing between WWE and AEW, and would say, "Bandido was in the same dilemma. He wasn't sure whether to go to WWE or AEW, but Dragon Lee was more like, there are so many people there, I'm just going to get stuck in the, I'm just going to go to WWE. He will blow everybody away. I don't see them all in WWE and I don't see it every week, but the last time I watched, which was maybe 2 or 3 months ago, there is nobody on his level there in NXT." Major League Wrestling have announced Alexander Hammerstone's next world title defense, with him set to battle Jacob Fatu at next month's Super Fight event, with them billing it as their biggest title match in company history. And they would say, "The biggest rivalry in MLW is finally getting the rematch to the biggest title fight in MLW history, as Hammerstone vs. Fatu 2 is set to main event Super Fight 23, an event worthy of such a colossal championship clash." Having won Battle Riot 4 in New York City last year, Fatu secured a title shot anytime, anywhere, and with the date and location confirmed, Fatu and Hammerstone rumble for the biggest prize in the sport on the line. Impact Wrestling have announced the return of ECW, WWE, and TNA legend Raven, who is set to appear at the upcoming Hard to Kill pay-per-view, although it remains to be seen what role he will play on the show. The event goes down this Friday night on Fight, with Raven set to take part in both the pay-per-view and the upcoming Impact Wrestling TV tapings the next night. And next, two top AEW stars are set to take an extended break. FTR's Dax Harwood and Cash Wheeler are coming off the back of 3 title losses, having dropped the IWGP, ROH, and AAA Tag Team Championships in a matter of weeks. First, they would drop the Ring of Honor straps to the Briscoes at Final Battle, before losing the AAA Tag titles to Dralistico and Dragon Lee, before finally losing the IWGP tag belts to Hirooki Goto and Yoshihashi at New Japan's Wrestle Kingdom 17. This week, Dax Harwood would address the future of FTR in All Elite Wrestling, revealing that he and his partner have requested to take some time off as they contemplate their next move once their contracts expire, and he would say, I have the blessing of Tony Khan to talk about this and make a statement about this. Tony has been nothing but top-notch to me and Dan Cash since day one. There are things we haven't agreed on, as any boss and any employee, even any friend. There are times that I felt the boat was missed on opportunities for us. There were times that I was super happy with everything we were doing, but there has come a time where we are on the tail end of our careers. Right now, at this point in our career, is the most important time in our career. I mean monetarily, creatively, and personally, it is the most important time in our career. With that said, we have asked and been granted the next few months off television so we can sit back, reflect, decide, let our bodies heal, and figure out what we're going to do for the next few years. Whatever we decide to do next will be the absolute last thing we do as far as wrestling. Harwood would then confirm that both he and Cash's contracts expire in early April, something that we recently discussed in our upcoming free agents video, before adding what will come into account when choosing their next step. And he would add, "By April, we will have an answer. I have to take my health, my family, my creativity, and I have to take my personal life all in consideration about what we're going to do next. I know what I want to do, but whatever we do, I just want to be respected. I feel we have done something so special in 2022, and most of that is part to the fans. We deserve to continue to build on our legacy for ourselves, but also we owe it to the fans to build on that legacy because they made us this past year. I'm not sure exactly how long we'll be away. It may be all the way until the end of our contract. Our contract is up in April." The last time we saw FTR and AEW was on the December 21st edition of Dynamite, which saw them lose to Austin and Colton Gunn. The Guns would then hold a funeral for the tag team, stating that they won't be back in the company, something that could turn out to be true depending on how things play out. But what do you think's next for Dax Harwood and Cash Wheeler? Let me know in the comments down below. And before we continue, if you're enjoying the video, why not drop a like down below, as it helps me out a lot. And be sure to subscribe to Wrestle Planet with notifications turned on so you don't miss the latest news from all around the pro wrestling world, and join us on the road to 50,000 subscribers. And next up, could Disney be set to buy WWE? This week, speculation emerged that Vince McMahon has sold WWE to the Saudi Arabian Public Investment Fund, although it later became clear that a deal is not yet complete. With that said, we have a major update that puts them in the conversation as potential buyers. Earlier this week, WWE would hire investment bank company JP Morgan as its sale advisors, this according to CNBC's Alex Sherman, with one of the reasons for this now seemingly being revealed. According to Cultaholic sources, JP Morgan were hired by WWE to advise on a sale because they are the only United States-based financial institution with two operating licenses in Saudi Arabia. This, of course, puts PIF very much in the conversation. Another WWE sale update comes from Dave Meltzer on Wrestling Observer Radio, who revealed that WWE CEO Nick Khan recently met up with two key figures from Disney and ESPN, which is owned by the Walt Disney Company, likely to discuss a possible sale. And Meltzer would note, "Nick Khan was in Los Angeles when I was in Los Angeles. He went to the football game Monday night, so he wasn't at Raw, and met with heavy hitters because they went to the college football championship game. Disney's Bob Iger, ESPN's Jimmy Pitaro, so I guess those names will ring some bells." And for our final update on the matter, a spanner may have been thrown into the works, as a WWE shareholder has filed a class action lawsuit against newly reinstated executive chairman Vince McMahon, which could lead to several more copycat lawsuits. The Wrestling Observer website notes that a suit has been filed in Delaware's Chancery Court, where shareholder Scott Fellows is accusing McMahon of using his 81% company voting control to remove three board members and replace them with his own hand-picked people, in addition to pushing through some bylaws that gave Vince McMahon the final say on any sale or media rights deal. McMahon wrote a letter to the board upon his return to warn that unless he was in charge, he would refuse to permit any sale or broadcast deals, a stance that may have some legal repercussions. And before you go, make sure you check out 10 upcoming wrestling free agents that you need to know.